Securing access to your company's resources from corporate devices alone is not sufficient in a hybrid work environment. Unprotected personal devices make your corporate resources more susceptible to being compromised. You may also be missing an opportunity to give more flexibility to your employees and boost their productivity. We often see that providing web access on personal devices to Office 365 is enough to boost productivity and give more flexibility to your employees. By allowing employees to check their emails, collaborate on Teams, and work on Office documents without allowing any download or content synchronization, you can empower users to do what they need whilst not sacrificing security. In this video, we show you how this scenario can be easily accomplished through the right combination of conditional access policies and recommended settings for both SharePoint and Exchange Online. If you're interested in a more advanced configuration, please check the link below.
So let's run through the process to set up the configuration you need to allow a secure web access experience for Windows personal devices using conditional access and the Microsoft 365 admin capabilities. First, you will need to configure SharePoint to grant web access only and restrict print, download, and the synchronization of files from the browser. The first step is to complete the actions required in the SharePoint Admin Center as shown on screen. This action will create two conditional access policies in your Azure AD tenant that can be modified to meet your organization's needs. It is important to note that these conditional access policies will be assigned by default to all users. The assignment can be modified to target only a group of users if you require. In this scenario, when we mention unmanaged devices, we consider non-compliant devices or not hybrid Azure AD joined. So it's important that all of your Azure AD managed devices meet your compliance policies. App enforced restrictions are checked on session controls. This setting will allow you to block the ability to print, download, and sync content from SharePoint Online and other applications or services that use SharePoint Online for file storage, like OneDrive and Teams. As a result, you can see here the user is in Teams trying to open a Microsoft Word document in Office, which is blocked as the device is not managed or compliant. This policy will affect iOS, Android, Windows, and macOS. If you already have created policies for personal mobile devices, make sure this does not conflict with them or exclude Android and iOS devices from the Conditional Access Device Platforms policy. If your goal is to make sure that download, print, and file sync are not allowed from the browser, conditional access policy settings will have to be set to allow limited access via PowerShell. Next, you need to configure Exchange Online to grant web access only. If you completed step one to secure SharePoint Online, we recommend you add Exchange Online to the conditional access policies and the same controls will be applied. As you can see here, we are adding the Exchange Online application to both conditional access policies previously created for blocking access from a non-managed device and enforcing app enforced restrictions from a browser. In addition, there is some PowerShell configuration required for Exchange Online to create a new mailbox policy to be able to enact the conditional access policies in the browser. Please review the links below to complete the steps required for this policy to take effect. After completing these steps, you can see here that the user is trying to download an attachment from Exchange Online using the Outlook web app, but they are blocked from doing this because the device is not managed or compliant. You might want to restrict web access to other services. If you are licensed for Microsoft Defender for Cloud Apps, you can leverage it to protect data with conditional access app control by applying access and session controls. If you cannot secure access to the services using app session control, then consider blocking them from unmanaged devices. Conditional access policies answer questions about who should access your resources, what resources they should access, and under what conditions. Policies can be designed to grant access, limit access with session controls, or to block access. You build a conditional access policy by defining the if-then statements. If an assignment is met, then apply the access controls.
Now that you've done this for Office 365 apps on personal devices, you should plan how you're going to build conditions that manage security controls that can block access, require multi-factor authentication, or restrict the user's sessions when needed, and stay out of the user's way when not. Take a look at our deployment guide below to help you. This video showed you how to configure SharePoint Online and Exchange Online access to grant web access only for non-managed devices. It also serves as a guide to configure the possible restrictions within browser access. The objective was to demonstrate some easy steps to boost your users' productivity, leveraging your existing Azure AD and EMS licensing. We recently announced that later this year, we will allow customers to apply edge protection policies for Windows that will add an extra layer of control to what we've shown you today. Take a look at the link below to discover how Windows powers the future of hybrid work.